So that season 3 trailer looks pretty amazing. Was that the first time you saw the trailer?
No, I had seen, I had seen some sneak peeks along the way as they were putting it together.
How do you think the tone compares to the previous 2 seasons? Is it going to get darker, rougher? What's it going to do?
Definitely darker. I think the show thrives being dark. And there's so much to explore, you know, going darker and darker, not just as the show in general, when we kind of delve more into all the different kinds of vampires, which you see a lot more this year. We introduce some new kinds of vampires, and my character especially gets to interact more with the vampires than with the humans, which was very interesting. And for my character in particular, yeah, things get dark. Which you can see in the sneak peek from, you know, that scene with the Scarlet character that she starts really struggling with some transformation inside with the bloodlust and stuff.
Did you know all along that this was going to be Endgame, that you were going to have that transformation?
No, I mean, I wondered. I thought, like, where can they take my character? And I think everybody fears being a vampire at some point. Like, season 1, it was like, no one wants to go through all that makeup.
Oh, yeah. Like,
right? But then when everybody who's actually done it then says, like, it was so worth it and amazing to be able to play that kind of a character. So I always wondered, like, how much I would start to dabble in, like, where they would take me with that or not. So this season explores that.
Does it touch into a darker side of her, maybe?
Definitely.
Than even before?
Yeah.
Not that she was a light character in the first place.
No, and she's written pretty dark, you know? You know, that being said, I always try to bring the humanity to her. You know, because it is a very dark show. It's a genre show. She's written so dark, but I always want it to seem real. Feel me? You know what I'm saying?
You're in a lucky position because you have a show that's on cable network that's also streaming on Netflix.
Yeah.
But it's also kind of a curse because then you have these people who only binge watch it, and then, you know, you've, like, you're waiting in the sense of, like, making sure that, you know, like, I work in television, like, you want people to watch it live. And so now you're trying to, like, garner a new audience of people, like, spending money. These, like, fight scenes are a lot more intense. So for those people who haven't been hit yet, like, what do you want them to know? What do you want us to share about the show? Let's say, hey, listen, binge watch season 1 and 2, and then when season 3 hits, watch it live every week.
Yeah, I think that's a real tough one in this day and age with the binging and the watching live. If it's there and people are going to binge, I really think that's just the truth of it. Some people wait, even if they could watch it live week by week. They're like, why would I want to do that to myself? Like, I'm going to wait for it's done, or I can binge it. I mean, it's a really interesting culture that we're in right now with the ability to binge and not. But I personally like having the week. I think it's really good for people to practice patience. I'm not going to hurt anyone, but it, the reason I do like it is it gives people time to absorb what happened. So many times I've watched, like, Handmaid's Tale on Hulu, for example, and I can't binge it, you know? But that whole week that I'm waiting in anticipation of what I'm thinking about it, it's kind of awesome, I think. Did I answer your question? Is that kind of what you were asking?
Yes, and then I was wondering, like, what you want us, and those who are telling people, like, okay, yes, we love the show, these are things, but what do you want us to say, hey, this is the reason why you should be watching it week to week?
Yeah, without spoiling.
Yes.
As opposed to binging.
Yes.
Or just watching in general, because I think people, like, we have our opinions about the show. For you as the person who's like creating the show, you know, what do you want us to share with the audience to say, hey, this is like why you should be tuning in?
I think I understand, you know, sorry if I took that into attention. You know, I think we're doing some really cool stuff for the genre that hasn't been done before, that's worth tuning in and watching. There's a lot, I think, of content out there right now of strong female-led shows. This one, in particular, I think deals with some... I think it's different and interesting because it deals with a lot of pain and loss and grief and darkness. And the character, my character, the main heroine, is really flawed. So I just think it's cool, kick-ass show. And if you like seeing women kick-ass and you like the genre, then it's the show for you.
Just Vanessa, like, now that she's going to be reunited with everybody from being held captive.
Is she reunited with everybody?
I mean...
Is that what you've been told, or is that what you gathered from what you saw?
Just from what I gathered.
Okay.
So...
Well, she's not reunited with everybody.
Okay.
So I'll say that. I would love for her to be reunited with everybody. I'm like, can I go back to the hospital? I'd love to the hospital, right? No, but the show's going in some really cool directions. What's it going to be like when she's reunited with Scarlett? That relationship takes some really interesting turns. It's trying to figure out how... I'm trying not to give away spoilers, but we do end up together again for a while. And we have to really face kind of our past together. I can't give away spoilers. This is so hard.
We missed you last year.
Thank you.
Obviously, you're pregnant.
Yeah.
You shot some scenes. How was it?
I shot a lot of scenes.
Was it majority of the season? Or?
Oh, yeah.
It was?
When we started shooting, I was 5 months pregnant, and I shot through 5, 6, and 7. And it was amazing. You know, I've been physically fit my whole life, and so when you become pregnant, you don't have to stop doing what you normally do. So I was able to continue to box, I mean, safely, and work out, and so I was able to still do a lot of the action in the fights. I obviously had to use a stunt double for some stuff, and they had to get creative with my wardrobe and how they shot, but I felt actually really empowered. As being the star of a strong female empowered show and being pregnant, I almost wish they would have written it in. I tried so hard. I tried it in. It's perfect. This would be so badass. You'd have me with like guns and a belt. Yeah.
Well, who would you want it to father to be then?
I mean, it could have been. Who knows? Did they impregnate her at the end of the season? Is it this next savior?
The next meal over
here.
Destroyer?
Do we protect it? Do we kill it? What do we do? Right? So I was pregnant, but I did do a lot. And it was an amazing experience working for him. Challenging, no doubt. You know, like as someone mentioned about how nasty we get, and there's so much mud season 2, a ton of rain, cold.
More blood, too.
But all that stuff, it just works, you know? Like, you're in hard circumstances as the actors, as the characters, I mean. So it's like, it just works. And then with the death of Dylan, in season 2, like I mentioned in the panel, being pregnant, too, was... You know, that's when I had that big scream. I don't know if you guys remember. If you don't watch that,
okay.
That big, grief scream when she died. You know, I was pregnant during that. It was amazing. It brought it being pregnant just really enriched everything for me. I recommend it.